بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله وكفى وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى أما بعد. Last week we spoke about this man, Uwais Al-Qarni, whose dua was readily accepted. Why? Because of his service to his mother. So much so that the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام asked Umar ibn al-Khattab رضي الله عنه that when this man comes to you, ask him to intercede on your behalf, to make dua on your behalf. And he did so. And we have mentioned that story in our previous episode. However, this man was so honored by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that it comes in a hadith of Tirmidhi that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not only honor this man's dua in this world, but it will be honored also in the next. Yes, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَوْمَ يَفِرُّ الْمَرْءُ مِنْ أَخِيهِ وَأُمِّهِ وَأَبِيهِ وَصَاحِبَتِهِ وَبَنِيهِ, that on that dreadful day, every single one will run away from each other. And they would be saying, نَفْسِي, نَفْسِي, يَا رَبِّي, نَفْسِي, نَفْسِي. So much so, it comes in the hadith that even the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would say, يَا رَبِّي, نَفْسِي, نَفْسِي. But it comes in a hadith mentioned by Tirmidhi rahmatullahi alayhi, that the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said, because of the intercession of a man from my ummah, a simple man from my ummah, more people than the tribe of Banu Tamim will surely enter paradise. Subhanallah. So because of an intercession of a regular man from the ummati of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasalam, more people than the tribe of Banu Tamim. Allah knows best how many people it had in the tribe of Banu Tamim, and they will be forgiven and enter into paradise because of its intercession. And Hassan al-Basri rahmatullahi alayhi says that this man is none other than Uwais al-Qarni. Subhanallah. So one might ask, how did this man live his life? Imam Hakim rahmatullahi alayhi, he mentions in his book Al-Mustadrak that Uwais was the monk of this ummah. Yes. He lived a life of absolute simplicity. He basically had nothing to do with this world. He was constantly worried about his akhirah, that what will happen to him in the hereafter. And actually, there's an incident that took place once. A man from Murad, from his city, passed by Uwais al-Qarni and said, how are you this morning? You know how you say, how are you? He said, I am this morning praising Allah. He said, how is life with you? What's going on? You know how we say, what's happening? He said, how is life with a man who in the morning thinks that he will not live until evening comes? And in the evening, he thinks that he will not live until morning comes. Subhanallah. And this is how Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us, that إِذَا أَصْبَحْتَ فَلَا تَنْتَذِرِ الْمَسَاءِ وَإِذَا أَمْسَيْتَ فَلَا تَنْتَذِرِ الصَّبَاحِ. What does this mean? It means that the Prophet ﷺ said that when you are in the morning, don't think you are going to make it till the evening. And if you're in the evening, don't think you're going to make it till the morning. There's no guarantee. Live your life as if this is your last breath and make the most of it. And that's how Uwais al-Qarni, he lived his life. Then he goes on to say that, and he will either be given glad tidings of paradise or tidings of hellfire. Then he goes on to address this man. He says, O man of Murad, death and remembrance of death do not leave any moment of joy for the believer. And this is also to substantiate this with a hadith where Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam tells us, أَكْثِرُوا مِنْ هَذِي مِنْ لَذَّاتِ يَعْنِي الْمَوْتِ, that continuously remember and remind one another about that thing that will destroy all pleasure, which is death. Death will put an end to all types of pleasure. And this is what Uwais al-Qarni, this is how he lived. And this is what he preached. He's telling this man that what good is life when a person knows that he's going to die. And how can he not prepare for akhirah when he knows he's about to die and he could die at any moment. And then he goes on to tell him that his knowledge of the rights of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not leave him with any wealth. What does that mean? That when he knows that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has rights upon him and the people around him has rights upon him, so then this man has no wealth left but that he distributes it to everyone else. Because you know they have rights on him. They know that charity is an important thing. They know giving zakat to the poor and needy, it's a very, very important thing. So they give nothing for themselves, but they give away everything that they possess. Then he goes on to tell this man that, and his standing up for the truth did not leave him with any friends. What does that mean? When a person will stand up for the truth, it's very possible that he will face opposition. He will get opposition and everyone's going to leave his side because he will have to stand up for the truth and not always would he get the support that he wants. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept us, to give us the strength to stand up for the truth and give us the strength to understand that we have to die and we have to leave this world. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for us to practice our deen and also preach it to others. On that note, I would request all of our listeners to please share this video. We ask you to share. Why? Because this is nothing to do with us, but this is to do with our deen. And when we spread the word of our deen, if through us someone is guided, if through our sharing of this video, someone changes their path, someone changes their lifestyle, inshallah, we can hope in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we will get the ajr as well and we'll be rewarded as well. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give us a lot in return in akhirah. Ameen ya rabbal alameen. Wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen.